Hello, I'm Mr. R. Niger, a retired lecturer in metallurgy preaching Christianity and Sikhism. And here I want to explain why St. James the Just, St. Stephen, when people were stoning to them to death, they were praying to our Father that, Father, don't accuse them. They don't know what they are doing. So forgive them. So they begged for forgiveness on their behalf. Whereas those people who were knowingly doing it and who knew what they are doing, as at the trial when they proclaimed that, oh, Jesus is proclaiming himself to be a king, when in their heart they knew he is not a king. He is not a king of this kingdom, but he is the royal king of our hearts. So such people who wanted to exploit others against Jesus are who are evil-hearted, and they know, they do the thing knowingly. They are called hypocrites. So Christ Jesus condemned hypocrisy the most, and he did not blame those people who were committed sins. Sins are committed under ignorance, or when you are you don't know what you are doing, when you are a child or something, you know, then you do this, commit sin. But when they are committed under, when you are knowing it and you are aware of it, then you are a hypocrite. So John the Baptist, when he was baptizing men in water, and those people who were not sensible, who were not of age, who do not know what they were doing, they, when they saw those temple priests in their silken robes, as you have today Pope with the silken clothes, and Orthodox bishops in Russia, they put on these funny dresses, very impressive, and many people go for them. Those who are sensible, they know such people are crook. Because in Christ Jesus, everyone has to give his own account to God, and they cannot give your account to God. So they don't go for them. Same way the people who went for John the Baptist to have the baptism in water in the name of Abraham, to become the sons of Abraham or sons of Adam, they were sensible people. They knew those temple priests, they are hypocrites. So such people who were sensible and who were baptized in the name of Abraham, they were handed over to Christ Jesus to be turned into sons of God. Remember, John said, I am baptizing you in water, one coming after me will baptize you in Holy Spirit. So this Christ Jesus did at the Eucharist of sacrifice, when he washed their feet and baptized them in the name of Father and Holy Spirit. This I have explained in my other videos, so it does not need to be reiterated. So people who are ignorant, who went for those temple priests who were dressed in the silken clothes. And today you have these people going for Pope because he is dressed and impressive. They don't know what they are doing. They are simpletons. They are once born. So as they are once born, if they do something wrong, that is forgivable, there, because it's a sin, you know. But when you have become sensible And then if you do something wrong, then that is not forgivable, because that is, you are spoken against the Holy Spirit. And speaking against the Holy Spirit is not forgivable. So that's why Christ Jesus said that you can say anything against me, against Father, but whosoever speaks against the Holy Spirit, he is not forgiven. So in Christ Jesus, we need to be sensible to understand his word. He came to preach gospel. Gospel is good news. Good news only you have when you understand the parables, the hidden meaning under the parables. Then that hidden meaning turned to be gospel. So these people who are hireling of mammon in churches, they are paid money. They say, if I tell them, you know, the gospel is by grace of God, not everybody can have it. No, every gospel is for everyone. So gospel is not that cheap. And there are very few sensible people who go for God. Out of the people you come across, many are just simpletons. Once born, they see the people, Orthodox bishops and other people, robed in silken, so they fall prey to them. And you can say, imagine how many are they out of 100, 70% go for them, you know. So what is left over 30%? And they are sensible people, and they like to go for mammon rather than God. If you go for God, then you don't charge money. These dog-collar priests who are the hirelings of mammon, they charge money from the people who invite them to say bless their house or to say prayer for them. They ask money from them. So they are not working for God, but for mammon, and they are hypocrites. So Jesus condemned the hypocrisy, not the sinners. Sins are against the transgression against the moral laws, and moral laws are taught to the children. Children, they feed on milk, whereas the sensible people who go for Christ Jesus and understand the parables, they feed on milk, meat. That's why Christ Jesus said when he broke the bread, this is my body, eat it. That means it's a meat. So his body is the gospel. So we need to be sensible and challenge these hypocrites. And they are so daring, you know, they are cheating the general people, public, in the name of Christ Jesus. They are well paid, people buy them cars, they live in nice houses, and they do not work, do any secular work. And they all live on widow's mite. People feed them, and they happily enjoy the feed, which is wrong. So Christ Jesus then he made a hue and cry against the hypocrites, and to expose the hypocrisy, the word of God is the only antidote. So you should have the gospel news. Understand the gospel to expose the hypocrites. If you do not understand the gospel, then you cannot expose them. And our Father bless you.